Welcome you boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. In this session, we try to understand a little bit about vapor pressure. If I take a liquid in a container and close it, the vapors generated on the surface exert a certain amount of pressure in an equilibrium situation. Now, the pressure exerted by vapors which are in contact with the liquids on its surface at any given temperature is called vapor pressure. Now, suppose I take the same very liquid in different type of containers. Say, suppose I take water in container 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In which case vapor pressure is more? Vapor pressure is exactly same in all the containers if the temperature is constant throughout. It means this equilibrium vapor pressure is not dependent on the surface area. This is a very important point. In an open container, the tendency of a liquid to escape into vapor state from the surface is called vaporization. The rate of vaporization depends on surface area. More is the surface area, more is the rate of vaporization. But vapor pressure is a property of a liquid in a closed container. It is the equilibrium vapor pressure. It depends on the nature of the liquid and also it depends on the temperature. Whatever may be the size and the shape of the container for a given liquid at a given temperature, vapor pressure is same. Generally, if I raise temperature, vapor pressure rises. Now, a temperature where the vapor pressure of a liquid is equal to 1 atmosphere is called its normal boiling point. If the vapor pressure of a liquid is equal to 1 bar, it is called standard boiling point. Next point. The variation in vapor pressure of a given liquid with respect to temperature is given by an interesting equation called Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Clausius-Clapeyron equation, which says that log P2 by P1 is equal to delta H by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. In this, P2 is vapor pressure at temperature T2, P1 is vapor pressure at a temperature T1, delta H is called latent heat of vaporization or enthalpy of vaporization, and here it is, R is universal gas constant. So, if you can measure the vapor pressure of a liquid at two different temperatures, a knowledge of T1, T2, P1, P2 will help you to find the heat of vaporization or enthalpy of vaporization. Or else, if you know the enthalpy of vaporization and P1 at a particular temperature, you can find the P2 at a different temperature. A graph of log P versus 1 by T looks like this. Can you guess what is the slope of this? Anyway, a liquid whose vapor pressure is very high is called volatile liquid. A liquid whose vapor pressure is less volatile or non-volatile. Water is practically regarded as non-volatile, though it has a moderate vapor pressure. Petrol, diesel, kerosene, carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide, all they are regarded as volatile liquids. Now, the factor that can affect this vapor pressure can be nature of liquid, can be temperature. It can also be the solute, number of moles of solute added. If the solute is non-volatile like urea, salt, glucose. Addition of a non-volatile solute to a particular solvent like water can lower the vapor pressure. The decrease in the vapor pressure due to addition of solute is called as a lowering of vapor pressure. If a liquid vapor pressure when it is taken pure is P0, if the vapor pressure of a solution due to addition of a non-volatile solute is Ps, P0 minus Ps is called lowering of vapor pressure. This divided with P0 is called a relative lowering of vapor pressure. Raoult's law states that the relative lowering of vapor pressure is always equal to mole fraction of non-volatile solute. All the solutions which strictly obey the Raoult's law are called ideal solution. In the next video, we talk about the Raoult's law in full detail and ideal, non-ideal solutions. Perhaps we may take 3-4 videos to come to complete the discussion on various cases of Raoult's law. For this, at this moment, thank you very much. Bye-bye.